Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup by People's Dispatch, where we bring you major news developments from around the world. Our headlines: Tunisia's President Kais Saied ousts Prime Minister and suspends Parliament. Pro-democracy MPs arrested by Swaziland forces as struggle continues. Protesters across the US demand an end to the blockade of Cuba. And in our video section, we take a look at the Fora Bolsonaro protests in Brazil as COVID-19 deaths cross 500,000. In our first story, Tunisia's President Kais Saied has suspended the country's parliament and has ousted Prime Minister Hichem Mechichi. Saied announced on July 25th that he would assume executive authority along with the new Prime Minister. The decision followed hours after thousands of people held protests across the country. They denounced the government's handling of the COVID-19 pandemic. As of July 24th, Tunisia had recorded over 560,000 cases and 18,369 deaths. Protests were held in several areas including Nabil, Tuzer and the capital of Tunis. People demanded the dissolution of parliament and reforms to address worsening socio-economic conditions. As protests continued on Sunday, the police officers deployed tear gas and pepper spray to disperse the crowds. Protesters reportedly also tried to storm the office of the Ennahda party, which holds the most seats in parliament. Mechichi's dismissal on Sunday follows just days after he removed the health minister Fawzi Mehdi. The health ministry had stated earlier in July that the health system had collapsed amid a spike in cases. President Saied declared that the army will now handle the pandemic response. He has also waived the legal immunity granted to members of parliament. The army was deployed outside government buildings in Tunis on Monday. The Speaker of the Parliament was also stopped from entering the building. News agency Al Jazeera reported that its offices had been stormed by soldiers and equipment had been seized. Protesters also gathered outside the Parliament to denounce what they called a coup d'etat. Clashes were reported after supporters of the President also arrived in the area. Meanwhile, Ennahda declared that Saied's decision was invalid and that Parliament would continue to be in session. President Saied has also declared that he will replace the Ministers of Defence and Justice. In our next story, we go to Swaziland, where two pro-democracy members of parliament were arrested on July 25th. Basede Mabusa and Thandeni Dube were taken to the police station and are now facing terrorism charges. They are among the growing number of legislators joining the people's demand for democracy. The arrests followed shortly after police attacked a funeral procession in Lomahasha. As reported by Swazi News, thousands of people had gathered following the killing of two civilian men. They were shot by an off-duty officer on July 18th after they denounced King Uswati III. Hundreds of residents then marched to the local police station to demand answers. However, the military was soon deployed to the region. These killings follow just weeks after at least 70 people were killed in participating in pro-democracy protests. At least 1,000 others were injured. However, the actual number of casualties is expected to be much higher. King Uswati III is Africa's last absolute monarch. He appoints the Prime Minister, the Cabinet and senior members of the judiciary. The people of Swaziland are demanding the right to elect the Prime Minister. They are also demanding a democratization of the economy and guaranteed access to healthcare and education. Swazi forces have responded to the protests with excessive force, including opening fire at unarmed civilians. Meanwhile, people have boycotted a dialogue process set up by the king. The Communist Party of Swaziland reported that empty buses and trucks left various areas after people chose to hold protests instead. In our next story, we go to the US, where countrywide protests against the blockade of Cuba were held on July 25th. The call had been issued by the Act Now to Stop Wars and End Racism, or ANSWER Coalition. The anti-war group is associated with the Party for Socialism and Liberation. Hundreds of people participated in the demonstrations held in several cities, including the capital, Washington, D.C. Protesters waved the Cuban flag and the flag of the 26th July movement. However, they were faced with several right-wing counter-demonstrations. Protests were also held in San Francisco, including a large caravan of cars and motorbikes. Outreach programs and other actions were also organized in Houston, Milwaukee, and New York. Sunday's protests followed shortly after Biden announced sanctions against Cuban Defense Minister Alvaro Lopez Miera. An entire security unit under the Interior Ministry has also been sanctioned for their role in supposedly repressing the protests. These measures are the latest in a series of unilateral actions taken by the US against Cuba. The Trump administration imposed a total of 243 unilateral coercive measures starting from 2017. These cost the Cuban government over $9.15 billion US between April 2019 and December 2020. Cuba was also redesignated as a state sponsor of terrorism earlier this year. Meanwhile, the over 60-year blockade has also restricted Cuba's access to basic goods, including food. And finally, we go to Brazil, where another round of mass protests was held on July 24th. Hundreds of thousands of people have continued to take to the streets against President Jair Bolsonaro. They're demanding his impeachment over the government's mishandling of the COVID-19 pandemic. Bolsonaro downplayed the crisis, refused to implement lockdowns, and delayed vaccine procurement. Brazil has witnessed nearly 550,000 COVID-19 deaths so far. Meanwhile, the president is facing a Senate inquiry and a corruption investigation related to a vaccine procurement deal. Brazilians are demanding better vaccine access and an extension of the emergency aid. Here is a video feature on Saturday's protests.
A gente está aqui mais uma vez num grande encontro na Paulista para derrubar Bolsonaro. Bolsonaro que negou as vacinas, Bolsonaro quer que o Brasil viva a normalidade no meio desse genocídio. E hoje é uma grande demonstração de insatisfação de que ele tem que cair para a gente continuar vivendo.
Queremos o impeachment dele e também por todos os atos dele contra a vacina.
Time for today. We'll be back tomorrow with more news from around the world. Until then, keep watching, keep listening.